Hi, I'm here with Sneshia Stribling. Hi, Sneshia.
Hi.
She is a graduate of our program. When did you come out of college?
I graduated in 2013.
Wow, I'm starting to feel old, as you
I
said.
I know.
Well, okay, 2013. And,
yes.
And good Lord, it's been that long. Okay.
I know.
And I thought it'd be good to talk to some of my alums. I'll try to have one every week, parents. I know you like these coming on here and get a lot of views, but I want you to hear from Sneshia. She's one of our plums, or chief, or there's a word for it, one of our chief plums from our program. And and I want her to talk first about, well, her family, all of them are real amazing. I just told them, sir, something about that. Each one of them is amazing. You'll get to see hear from her brother in a couple of weeks. But I thought I'd have her on first. She's got another brother. He's amazing, too. I follow him. He doesn't know it. You know, and the mom is amazing, too. But that's not why we're here. We're here to talk to Sneshia. So, Sneshia, I want you just to go ahead and trace from where you went to high school, when you came out, and how you found us and stuff like that. Go ahead. Wait. So I raise my hand. I have a question. Go ahead.
Yes. Okay. So I met Deacon. I believe it was in 2005. I was 15. I was in 10th grade. I met him through one of my best friends. She was actually going to the education enrichment program, and I just started going. She was like, "Yeah, they do tutoring and everything." So I was like, "Okay, I'll go." So that's how we met. And then my brother was actually a senior.
Mm-hmm.
So I was in 10th. He was in, I think, 12th grade. Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So when I came along, then he came also. So the whole clan. Then I have two more siblings after myself. So that's what happened. So we met, and then I completed the program. He helped with the SAT prep. And so I graduated from View Park Preparatory Accelerated Charter High School.
Oh, first, yeah.
First graduating class, 2007.
Yeah, I know.
He helped me with my college applications. I think I didn't get accepted into one college, but I applied to about seven and I got accepted into pretty much all of them. I was supposed to go to Biola University. The funding I could not afford. It was the financial aid. I think I was like $6,000 short.
Right.
And I would have to take a bus and just all type of cars and things like, I didn't drive at the time. So it just would have been a hassle trying to get there. And so I applied to this one school, Cal State San Bernardino, and they were the only school that had housing left because I wanted to live on campus.
Right.
And so Deacon was like, "Well, what do you want to do?" And I said, "I'm just going to go there. It's fine." And so I went there. I finished. I got my bachelor's degree in psychology. And so after I graduated, I was accepted back and I got my master's in social work.
That's right. You psychology, then social work.
Yes.
And then where did you work after that?
So I applied to this Title IV program.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. And so pretty much that's the program that will pay for your education, but you have to work. The payback is that you work 2 years. You can work more, but you have to work the 2 years.
If your master's, right?
Yes, this is for my master's. Yeah. So I work.
You still do that. Go ahead.
Yes, they still, yes. USC. So here's the thing. So I applied to more than one grad school. And the only one that actually accepted me was Cal State San Bernardino. I was going to do USC, but Deacon was like, "Why would you pay all that money? Just go back to your old school." Yeah, you're right. So I went back, they accepted me, and I worked 2 years at the county. That was all I could do, 2 years. My title was, I was an SSP, so social service practitioner. I was a intake worker.
I learned what that was.
Yes, my job was to remove children from abusive and neglectful homes. So I did that for 2 years.
How'd that go at first?
It was very challenging and scary. It was very scary.
How so?
Because even though we went through training for about 3 months, they just throw you in there. So it's like you shadow people for a little bit, maybe a month, if that. And then after that, you're on your own. It was scary because I wasn't used to going into those type of neighborhoods. So San Bernardino is very, very huge. It's a large county. And the areas that we service were like the low socioeconomic areas.
That's right.
So a lot of Black families, a lot of Hispanic families, and even some Caucasian families that are not wealthy. And so it was just traumatic because—
What'd you see?
The conditions of the home, the largest group that I removed was 13 kids from one home.
Oh, I didn't know about that.
Yes.
13
from one home. And a lot of the services I feel like are handicapping our parents because when they were younger, they were in the system. So it's like a vicious cycle.
Okay.
Yeah. So that is what I had to experience.
What were some of the reasons for removal?
So we would remove them if, so neglect can be like if they're not feeding them, if they are like beating them. And I would say beating, like if you're hitting them and you leave a mark, they have several marks. That's one. It could be just the conditions of the home, and if it's really deplorable and unlivable, but the kids are still there. That's one. And emotional abuse can be one, sexual abuse can be one, and of course physical abuse. So we would remove for those type of things.
And what if, as time went on, what impact did it have on you?
It was to the point where I developed a anxiety and depression and a heart condition. I had pericarditis, so my heart was swollen, but that was due to stress. Yeah, so stress. I would work like 24-hour days at the job. And then I would bring my work home. And then even when I would come to LA, I would bring my work home. So yeah, it was very intense. Very
traumatic. Your kind of track real quickly your relationship with God and how did it grew probably from it, but how did that help you get through it? Did it help? Talk about it.
I prayed a lot. I did. I prayed because I knew I wanted a way out. And I started going to, I was already in therapy when I started Cal State, which is great. I went to therapy. I would talk about it as far as like, you know, what we did and things like that at the job. And I had a great support system as far as like my supervisor and my team, my coworkers, but I just think management didn't support as much as they should have. But my relationship with God grew because I knew that he was going to get me out of there. I just needed a way out. So I always would pray and just be like, I can't do this anymore. It's just not for me. Well, you make all this money.
Yeah.
But you're not enjoying the money.
Right.
That's not a way to live.
Well, you were very resilient, that's for sure. And what about kids will tell me sometime when I tell them they need to see a counselor when they're in college and they're reluctant because they don't want to seem crazy or something. And what would you say to those kind of people?
How would you encourage them? I think like with the Black community, with us, just Black folks in general.
It's a cultural thing,
Yes, it's definitely a culture thing. And we always say therapy is for white people, quote unquote. I think that's a very ignorant statement because it's for everyone. If you feel like, I mean, God put therapists here. God is the number one, of course, but he put therapists here for us to talk about our problems and for us to work through them. So I was very I was very, very satisfied that when I started college and I was at Cal State San Bernardino, that they had therapy. I didn't know it. I knew about therapy, but again, I was one of the people that was just like, I'm good, I can handle it. But it opened me up in so many avenues that, you know, I was able to express myself and I was able to like change my major because I was pre-med at the beginning of my career. And I actually spoke to Deacon about it because
I remember. Like,
It's also a cultural thing when you say you want to be pre-med and the parents are like, that's my baby. They just want to brag. It's bragging rights. but the yes, the money is great, but the education part of it is very rigorous.
Hard.
It's, oh my goodness. So you're going to have to take math, on top of science, on top of that science. And so I just really broke down and told Deacon, like, this isn't for me. I can help people, but just not in that.
Yeah, path. I think we identified you want to help people.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yes.
So okay. So what do you do now? What's going on? You've been there a while, is my impression.
Sorry?
You've been working there quite a while, is my impression. You took a little break, I know, but go ahead.
Mm-hmm. So after I resigned from the county, I took about 4 months, 4 or 5 months off just to gather myself and get myself together. And then I started this job at, I work for PATH. So that's people assisting the homeless. I work in veteran services. Bye-bye. So I help veterans, homeless veterans find housing.
Still doing social work, see?
Yes, I'm still doing social work. And it is because a lot of the veterans, majority, all of them, they have mental illnesses.
Right.
You know, they have broken families. They come from broken families and things like that. So it's also like a clinical piece. So I was able to complete my clinical hours and I'll be taking my licensing test next year.
Wow. So. I didn't know you were that close. Wow.
Yes, I finished my hours at PATH, actually.
Yeah, that's mm-hmm. what, you know, Nicole, she's doing that now, too, just finishing up that. She's in another part. She worked in another part of the county.
Oh, nice.
She worked for L.A. County, and she worked in a different type of area. But
yeah.
Anyway, so, hey, why don't you, we got students that are undecided in their careers and, mm-hmm. and also students in high school that had it rough during the pandemic and are figuring out where they fit and
mm-hmm.
give some quick advice to some of these youth. Just going your own way for a few minutes here. What would you say?
Excuse me. Sorry about that.
No problem.
I would say for the first 2 years of college, you're taking your prerequisites. So you're taking your English, you're taking your math. You don't have to jump right into a major. I would say take things that kind of interest you. Like maybe if you like writing, take a writing class. If you like art, take an art class. Just take some electives that interest you. And then maybe you can get a feel of what you want to do. If I can do it all over again, I would have done that. And I think it would have helped me realize that I wanted to go into social work. Instead, I just majored in psychology, but I could have been, majored in, you know, my undergrad could have also been in social work. And then just talk to your counselors. Definitely talk to your college counselors. My counselors were amazing. I had some Black sisters. They were the best.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Yeah. And I also had a Black gentleman. He helped me as well. So you just have so much support on campus. So just utilize that. And then for me, even though I figured out I wanted to do social work later on in my college career as an undergrad student, I took a social work class. It was like a Black sociology class.
Mm.
And that just captivated me. And it was just like, okay, this is what I want to do. I want to go into social work. And then my mentor was the associate director of the psychology department. And so she was a Black lady. She was a Black lady. I met her through one of my guy friends. And he was like, you got to meet her because I know that you guys will click. And we still talk to this day. We text on and off. But she helped me get into the master's program.
I was going to say, she let you know you had a pathway.
Yes. And she wrote me a letter of recommendation. So I would just say utilize the staff. Talk to different people. You know, you can get involved. I got involved later on when I was like a junior in college. But yeah, get involved and just take electives that interest you. And then that way you can get a feel of what you want to do. If, like I said, I would have done that if I had more guidance. But now that I know, then I can just give my wisdom to other people. And that would be my advice. Just take electives that you think that you may want to do.
Very cool. Hey, I'm glad you did add that part about in college, because I forgot this is going to be on Holy Diggers EDU, which is the current college student channel I have. Okay. And they do look over there, and we have a newsletter that goes out to the college students. We can do a lot with alums now. Ones who are on the campus first, and now I'm reaching out to you guys.
Yeah.
Like an informal army that I have. So I really appreciate you doing this. And once we get into our new building behind the cathedral, I'm going to be doing very regular career and mentoring panels. And anybody who I'm interviewing now, you're the first one. Everybody sees that. I mean, I did some beta testing last year, but this is it. I'm hoping we'll be on that panel. And I want to form an alumni career group that just like a resource for students that are looking for careers, if that's okay with you.
Awesome. Yeah.
Professor Stribling.
Yes.
Look, just kind of jousting you before we go here. Great, go. But now the pandemic's over. Looking forward to having, I actually want to take you and Rashad out somewhere.
Yeah, your birthday was just so awesome.
Oh, yeah, you like that.
You put me on the spot, Deacon, but I hope I get
know,
okay.
I know, you made me cry. Stop that. I want to tell you that. Hey, by the way, appreciate you coming. Were you shocked? Okay, last question.
Yeah.
Were you shocked that I was 65?
You look great. Nope. You look like you're 50, okay?
Nice recovery. But I bet when she says the 65th when you're invited, you would say, wow, right?
I was like, not 65 already?
Yeah. I mean, I was going to retire about, what, 3-4 years ago with the pandemic hit.
Yeah,
but I'm glad I stayed. I'm going to be around for a while.
Absolutely. They need you. Well, if I know any young people, I definitely would try to refer them to you. And I always speak highly of you because you change people's lives. You changed our lives. I have 3 other siblings, so it's all together 4 of us. And you were, like, I always say, like a surrogate father to us. I remember the story. We'll have to talk about it offline. But you just have always been such a support and just with everything. So I love what you're doing, and I would love to give back to anybody if they want to go into social work, because social work is very broad. You can do a lot, and you don't have to go to SC. And I always felt like,
yeah, I had absolutely. To go to SC. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh my God. And then yeah. I know you I don't want to talk about it here, but I know yeah. you followed some of the things going on with their social work school.
I don't know. Look, we gotta talk about that.
All right. Well, as soon as I get off this, I just want to tell you about it. We need to keep them in prayer. And I thought about you and others who I persuaded to do it at CSU under Title IV or go a different direction, because the cost is just phenomenal. It's $83,000. It's $83,000 to go to USC now.
Ooh, it was cheaper. Definitely cheaper at CSU.
Way. Yeah. Well, look. Thanks a lot, Sneshia.
Thank you.
We will do it again, but in a different context. Once we get in a new building, I'm going to be streaming a live panel. That's what I have a vision for. And I'd love you to be the host of the panel.
Yes, I would love it.
Yeah, you know. All right. Well, I'm going to weave my way. I'm going to do Rashad up here soon and get you five key people. And then we'll talk about that. We're moving in probably early next year.
To the new awesome.
Building. If you go down Crenshaw, don't be shocked. Everything's gone.
Oh my God, really?
Church was tore down. The youth center's not there. There's a building there. And if you ever drive through there intentionally and see how it's changed. And we have a new building behind the cathedral that we're going to move into. I'm working at home right now, but I'm doing a lot of work in the community. And we do have our after school in the cathedral. So,
awesome.
All right. Holla at you. Thanks a whole lot. I appreciate it. Thank you. So I hope you parents enjoyed it. Remember to click like and subscribe if you want to see more things like this. Do some comments below. Let me know what you think about this. Thanks much. Bye-bye now.